Hi guys, Carl from carlvanderpauw.com. In this video, what I'm going to show you is how to install the free JW Player so you can play videos within your WordPress website. So the first thing you need to do is log in to your WordPress admin panel, then come down to plugins, and then obviously come down to add new. Now what you want to do here is click on the search term in here and type in JW Player. And then hit search plugins. Okay, the one you want is this one here because it's also Flash and HTML5 equivalent. And all that means is that if a device like a PC or a laptop visits your site and views the video, it will show the Flash version. But if somebody comes to your site and comes with another device like an iPhone or an iPad or something other than a PC or a laptop, it will then switch to the HTML5 view. Okay, so the next thing we need to do is obviously click on Install Now and click on OK. Okay, once that's done, what we need to do is activate the plugin. Okay, now that we have it activated, we have to go to the settings. So what we need to do is come down to the JW Player here, click on the drop down menu, and click on JW Player. Okay, first thing we need to do is make sure we have the latest version of the JW Player. So just click on this button here, and then it'll install the latest JW Player. And there we have it. So let's just click back here again to the JW Player. Now all this is down here is the standard video player, but what we want to do is we want to actually create a new player that will allow you to embed your videos to the same size as your YouTube video, because as you see here, the height and width is not what we want, and it has a standard player. And what we want to do is optimize this particular player with a bit of SEO optimization as well. So what we need to do first of all is come to your particular YouTube channel here, and what you want to do is come down to the share. Okay, so what we're targeting here is the optimal size of 640 wide by 360 pixels high. So let's go create that in our new JW player. So what we want to do is create a custom player. Okay, let's name the custom player. Now, whatever your site is about, say for example, mine's on video SEO. Okay, so I'm gonna name my player what my website is about. So if yours is dog training, call it the dog training player. Now, I like to have the control bar to the over position. The skin, instead of the default, I like this particular skin here. And from here, the height is what we talked about before, is the 390 by 640 high. And all the rest of the advanced settings and ad server settings, a lot of these you don't need to touch, but you can certainly have a look if you're looking to make any extra changes. So other than that, what I'm gonna do is hit the save button, and there we have it. So we've now got our player rocked and ready to go with a bit of video engine optimization, or like basically search engine optimization in the actual player itself. So what we need to do now is come back to our specific video, and we obviously copy the URL from the address bar. And what we're going to do now is embed this particular video into a post. So we come up to a post and click on all post. Okay, so we're just going to embed it into the Hello World post. So I'm going to click on Edit. Okay, I'm just going to expand this window by just clicking and dragging that down. Now what I want to do is have my video at the top of the page, so I'm just going to bump that down a bit. Now what I'm going to have to do is come up to here and click on Add an Image. Now what you will notice here is there's an extra panel here. We have the external media. So, but what we first want to do first off is add a what we call a video still. Now, remember how we talked about the size of 640 by 390? I've already previously made a video still. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this and upload that file, so we've actually got a video still. I'm just going to select this image here that I've made before, which is the right dimensions. Now, what you will notice is I've also optimized the actual file name, so YouTube subscription widget. Then click on open. Okay, once that's done, what I'm going to do up here is go to the external media. Okay, and then all we do from here is paste our YouTube video in there. And we hit add media. Okay, and what it does is actually grabs the title, the description, and any sort of links or anything from here from the actual channel itself. Okay, so I'm just going to keep that as it is. So obviously keep the title there, just leave the caption alone, put the description, leave the description there. For the link URL, I'm just going to select that as none. Now with the thumbnail, instead of pulling the YouTube thumbnail, which is what it's done, is I'm going to select the one that I've actually just uploaded here. So it's a nice, clear, crisp one, rather than the one that YouTube uses, which may be a bit blocky. So I don't want to do any download file, but the HTML file, now as I said before, when a PC or a laptop comes to the site, it actually shows the Flash version. But for the device, like a smart device, like an iPhone or an iPad or anything that doesn't have Flash installed, it will then switch to the HTML5 version and then obviously keep that video there. So I'm just going to drop this one down here and select that. And from up here, I'm just going to wipe out this, like so. Now, remember how we created that player before? So select the player, and we're going to embed the video SEO into the page. So there we go. It's actually got a bit of shortcut code, so rather than having an embed really, really long code, it actually is just the shortcut code, so you don't have to know anything from there. And all we have to do is just hit publish or update. Now what we do is, obviously, we want to go preview those changes. So let's go have a look at what it looks like in the default template. Okay, so we scroll down here, and this is the player that we created before, so it's a nice looking player, as well as the video still. That looks really, really good. So it's a lot more crisper and cleaner than the usual YouTube ones. And that's the end of the tutorial. If you like this tutorial, make sure you subscribe to my channel, and also come to my site at karlvanderpower.com for more free tips on WordPress and video SEO. Thank you.